Before this week, I knew three things about One Direction, and that was that they were a boy band, there were five members, and they were in a UK television show called The X Factor, which might be a television show in America, but I'm not sure because we have a lot of talent-based television shows like that, so it's kind of hard to keep track of them. I also knew that Harry was the one with blonde hair. No, Harry's the one with curly hair. I also knew that. But now I know a few things because I went on Wikipedia, I did my research, and I found out that the One Direction page, the Wikipedia page, and all of the pages for like the members, the little like synopses that are in One Direction, are definitely written by 12-year-old girls. Like every single fact. And I know this because every like piece of information, I mean, I'm not judging 12-year-old girls. I'm really not. Like, and I know that if you're a 12-year-old girl, that is awesome. That is really great. Good for you. what I'm trying to say is that I can tell that their fans wrote like the Wikipedia pages because there's just so much information that make like it's not relevant at all to the things that you would put in like their basic outlines. Like, you know, when you're reading like in the One Direction page and you're reading like basic little things, little excerpts about each of the band members, you want to know like where they grew up. And, like, maybe, like, a special talent, or, like, where they went to school, or maybe just, like, what they do in the band, what they look like. I don't need to know that one of the members, like, used to smoke cigarettes, and now he doesn't. I don't need to know, like, everything they posted on Twitter, and what that means, and, like, that relevance to their lives. And I'm really glad that most Wikipedia pages aren't written that way, by fans who just know, like, every single fact and really want to get out, like, every piece of information they know about the person. Because if every Wikipedia page was written that way, I would be failing school because I would just know so much useless information about the topics I'm given and I wouldn't know anything of importance. We started this week with Sonnet talking about Harry. Oh, not our Harry. The Harry in One Direction. I think he's the cutest one of the entire band because I like his hair. There you go. I'm a teenage girl. I share the same mentality as everyone else in the world. Except Mary, who we talked with on Tuesday, who discussed Louis. Louis, I don't know which one he is, but I know he's not Zayn, because I thought Zayn was the one I looked up. Because Harry talked about a few of them, and then Lloyd talked about Niall, the one who looks like Ellen DeGeneres. A little bit. He does look a little bit like Ellen DeGeneres. But nobody has Ellen DeGeneres' eyes. Oh, those eyes. Like, seeing into her soul. I wish I looked like Ellen. Oh, we should have an Ellen DeGeneres week. Oh my gosh, guys, can we do that? I'm proposing it right here on camera that we have an Ellen DeGeneres week, because there's so much we could talk about. Her being a comedian, her talk show. She was on, like, another television show. She's so good. I love Ellen DeGeneres. We all do. That's the only channel we subscribe to, I'm pretty sure, is Ellen DeGeneres on the Collaborative Cadaver channel. It's really great because whenever I get on our channel, I end up watching a lot of, like, Ellen, like, whenever she interviews someone or has, like, little, like, games on her show. Yeah, okay, One Direction. Because everyone else talked about those people, I got to choose between Liam and Zayn. And I started looking up facts about Zayn, but then I was really distracted by the way the Wikipedia page was written because it was just, like, so much information. Yeah, he's the cool one. He has, like, really spiky hair and he has, like, I think, like, highlights and I don't know, that makes him cool. You know, in the 90s, the Backstreet Boys had, like, really, like, you look back on it and you probably think, like, oh, they probably looked really hot for the time. Like, they probably were really, really attractive guys in the 90s. Like, I mean, they had to have been because everyone loved them. And I'm not saying they weren't attractive, but, like, just some of the choices they made in wardrobe and in hair was really, really questionable. Like, the macaroni hair with JT, I don't know. I kind of wonder if people are going to look back on, like, One Direction and be like, oh, those are good-looking guys, but can you believe what they were wearing? But yeah, Backstreet Boys definitely had a weird wardrobe consultant. I really miss macaroni hair. So let's talk about Zayn. My Zayn man. A Zayn in my ass. Sorry. Oh, that's terrible. I thought it'd be really easy to make jokes out of his name, but I forgot that I'm not funny. Zayn's favorite band of all time is NSYNC. By the way, I don't know if any of this is valid. I typed in facts about Zayn, and this came up. 101 facts about Zayn, exactly what I wanted. Zayn has a total of 8 tattoos on his body. The most recent is a life-size microphone on his right forearm that he had done in Los Angeles in June 2012. Zayn loves posing topless. However, He says he's too shy to pose naked.
Really?
Really? I doubt a member of One Direction is super shy. But hey, I don't know him. Zayn loves drawing when he has spare time. Oh, he's a quiet artistic type. The one artist Zayn would love to collaborate with is Bruno Mars. I want to collaborate with Olivia Newton-John. I think we would have really good chemistry. Last fact I'm going to read, because I'm not going to read all 101. Zayn's favorite food is chicken. Cannot relate to you there, Zayn, but I appreciate the originality. So I just went on Spotify, kind of like one-hit wonders. Like, it was just like, because I only hear those few songs on the radio. One Thing and then What Makes You Beautiful. Beautiful? What makes you beautiful? What makes you beautiful? Sorry, it was a long day. I don't know why I feel so patronizing right now. I know they're good musicians and they're good guys, and I'm just surprised because I've only heard two songs of theirs. I've tried playing it cool, but when I'm looking at you, I can't ever be brave, 'cause you make my heart race. Shot me out of the sky.